Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, two AFC teams set to do battle, as we've got a good one in store between the Denver Broncos and the Cincinnati Bengals. This is taken at the 3. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. They'll come out in the pistol. Now a carry. It's C.J. Anderson. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down.
I'm not sure that the re-signing of C.J. Anderson in the offseason wasn't one of the bigger moves by an NFL team, because he provides them some toughness running the football. He pass protects really well. And he kind of sets the tone for Denver when they're on offense.
Against the Colts, he had 74 yards in week 2. Devontae Booker is a nice change of pace guy to have with him, isn't he?
Hard to believe they got him in the 4th round. One of the better runners in the country. Actually likes to carry the ball in his left hand, reminiscent of a great runner in the past.
And still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down.
C.J. Anderson may not be a Pro Bowl runner, but he knows how to run big in big games.
Yeah, he sort of sealed the Super Bowl for them in the 4th quarter. Big game against the Patriots last year on a Monday night, but only 720 yards all told in 2015. Now Anderson. And tough going there as he'll only get it up to about the 31. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a 4th down.
But forget knowing where the 1st down line was. This defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. If you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They have more people to the football and snuffed out the play.
Here's Jones. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that officially. Give him 15, and possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. The 1st down throw coming for Dalton. Finding time. And he's got the hookup to Brandon LaFell. And he's brought down. 15 yards here on the catch and run.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
So the offense has it 1st and 10. First and 10 for Dalton. Brought in here by Tyler Eifert. And he's brought down. And give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
Fakes the give to Bernard. Dalton backing up. And over the middle, it's LaFell. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there, a 22. So there on that play, offensively, they ran the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let him know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play. In today's NFL, you hear all the time about stretching the field and creating space in order to run plays. A toss play will help accomplish that because now you're pushing a defense to chase you all the way to the edges and to the sideline. That's a nice run, probing now early to try and get things done later.
Now Bernard, and it'll be a minimum pickup here as it will take us to the end of the first quarter. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gordon, and it's the Bengals with the football to begin quarter number two. And they're driving, but they come up on a third and short here. Dalton gives to Bernard, and he'll get blown up behind the line of scrimmage. Back at the six, he loses four, and it brings up fourth.
And partner, in a lot of short yardage situations, you'll see the linebackers step up into the gaps, what we call mugging the line of scrimmage, to make sure they take away all spaces, all creases. That one worked really well for them.
Now only needed a yard, instead went backwards. And the 11-year veteran bangs it through, and the Bengals are on the board first here. It's 3-0. So after slogging through a scoreless first quarter, we have action on the scoreboard. A field goal makes it 3-0.
Well, with these two offenses, we weren't going to stay 0-0 forever, were we? I'm not sure that this opens the floodgates, but I doubt that's the last scoring we're going to see.
Back out Nugent now after the field goal as he'll send it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And the first drive, 3 and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. There's Anderson as they begin this series on the ground. And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
But we just saw the recipe for success right there. Big body, strong, agile, playing with great leverage and hands. Not really able to be blocked on that play. Close things down inside.
Simeon. And it's caught over the middle by the tight end, Green. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You're getting better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
Now Simeon. And this is going to be incomplete. Devontae Booker, the man he was trying to get it to. And it'll be fourth down.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they run successful.
Here's Riley Dixon now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Bengals take possession. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 points.
The kicker.
Exactly. He put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Toe bashed it.
Super toe. Man, it wasn't that long ago that the guy playing that spot was an outside linebacker type of a guy. Now, as a defensive end, how about the speed that he used to get into the backfield and make the play?
It's now time. Hey, 380. 380.
They'll run again with Bernard. Yeah, he had a quick little spin move, but the door shut fast as he's dropped. Give him two on that run, and they're still left looking at a third and about nine to go.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Dalton sets up play action. He's got time. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And that'll bring up fourth down. Good play there to step in and knock that one away by Chris Harris.
Who said that he couldn't play in the NFL?
Not me.
Not you. A lot of scouts did, a lot of people undrafted, and has turned himself into a Pro Bowl cornerback, one that really knows how to play the position.
This is brought in at the 21. And there's a flag on the field. Thomas, the lone receiver, left. They'll look to throw now on first down. And the catch made. This is Emmanuel Sanders. 5 yards on the pickup, and it's a second down. And the offense moving quickly to the line. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. He goes underneath for Anderson. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Back to throw now on first down. Looking left side and completing it to Thomas. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. 6 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second down. They're going to hurry back to the line now. They'll drop the throw. Room here to run. And avoids the contact by sliding. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs. Creeping up on a minute to play in this first half.
Here we go. Green, 39.
Simeon. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete.
Now let's go.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Pass incomplete.
When you see passes knocked down by those guys I call the frustrated fullbacks, the linebackers, you know that in their zone coverage, they were able to drop, see the ball thrown, and react to it very quickly.
And a nickel look here for the Bengals as they try to defend this on third.
Let's go!
No. Check.
Now Simeon. He's got time in the pocket. He shakes him off. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. It's second down. Dalton looking. He gets this one to Boyd. And out of bounds. begins on the other side of midfield at the 45.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target, and he's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read
that. Now, whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. Another chance for Dalton to the left side here for Eifert. And he gets it down to the 32. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you...
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get three before halftime. He was true on his first. This a tough one from 49 yards away. And that is not going to get there. Oh, he missed it short. It's no good. And this score will stay right where it is. So a bit of a weird kick there. That wasn't an overly long attempt, but that never had a chance.
You almost wonder if he might have maybe got that one on the laces because it kind of knuckled on him a bit. And this one winds up in empty possession.
13, three receivers to the left, one to the right. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Surveying the field. Looking deep for Demarius. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, where Larry Ridley has our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, this fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Bengal offense now with a football first here to begin quarter number three. They have the lead now. They'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. Change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
We'll see if they do just that. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
Caught Eifert over the middle. It's a pickup of six and good enough to move the chains.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on, catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
So here we go, first and 10 now. They come up in an offset eye. Now a carry for Bernard. So quick on the spin.
He's spinning, man.
And the cutback to the sideline. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Bengal TD. Giovanni Bernard, 68 yards. And the Bengals are able to grow their lead. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
After the touchdown, here's Mike Nugent now to kick this one away. This will be taken in at the one. And not a bad return here. He gets it out to the 25-yard line. A look at the offense now here, coming back out on the road for their first possession of the second half. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter three, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned. Because some teams script to start a half, other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Vontaze Burfict, the one to get him down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first-level run, and it was stopped by a second-level player.
Let's go! Green, 39!
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete. He was trying to get it to Benny Fowler that time, and that'll make it third down. A pretty good coverage there in both of these defenses. They've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Give him six on the play, and that's going to bring up a fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Averaging over 50 yards a punt so far as this one's away. And that hits at the six and carries into the end zone for a touchback. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. They'll begin here with Bernard. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front, because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second down following the run. Again, here's Bernard. And this time not as successful, as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage. And the Broncos go to a nickel set on third down.
Yeah, they've got an extra DB out there. Third down from the gun. Dalton finding time. He's got his man here. It's Green. 12 yards there as they move the chains.
There's nothing like getting out of the gate and finding your favorite target. Andy Dalton just did that with A.J. Green.
And some people call that a nice fantasy football connection as well.
Yeah, they're piling up the points that way, and they wanted to see that continue.
The first down throw coming for Dalton. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Okay, let's talk rookies here while we have a second. Who's impressed you through the first couple weeks of the new guys?
Well, a decent number of players, but I'm going to down focus a little bit here, okay? Because we've talked about the rookie quarterbacks, Dak Prescott in Dallas being one of them. But don't forget the runner, Ezekiel Elliott. He's really starting to come on. And then flip it over to the defensive side. The San Francisco 49ers have played pretty tough in the first couple of weeks. DeForest Buckner out of Oregon, he's doing a really nice job on the defensive side.
And Corey Coleman, Will Fuller, a couple guys on the offensive side switching it back there. They've been really good.
They know how to find the end zone, don't they? They get there, and they get there in a hurry. And that was a big-time play by the defense because everything was set up for the offense to be successful. Nickel package, you run the draw, you expect to get a big guy out in space on a smaller defensive back to block him. That didn't happen on this play.
Throwing, Dalton. And that is incomplete. Back now in Cincinnati. It's the Bengals in possession of the football and in possession of the lead as well as we start the fourth. This is taken at the 15. Almost outkicked his coverage there. 48-yard punt, but 10 on the return. And the Broncos take over. First down and 10. Here's the Denver offense now as they get set to take over here. And three and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul searching now?
I would say so. And they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've had to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
Now Simeon. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it.
Hey, here we go now. Green.
Simeon. Over the middle this time to Fowler. And he's brought down after a good gain. 23 yards on the play.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
And now a first down following that long gain.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. He's had no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Michael Johnson in there to sack him for a loss of six. Boy, he came in off the edge so quickly there.
Look out, because that's exactly what it was being shouted by the offensive lineman to his quarterback because he had no chance to block him.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
All right, here we go. Boom, landed.
From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he's got it, complete to Fowler. And he's out of bounds just before the midfield stripe at the 49. He had time, was able to survey the field, and find a soft spot in that zone coverage.
And that's where it gets difficult for a defender, Brandon. You go to your spots on the field that you have to cover, and when the offense finds an area that you're not in, that's where they throw the football.
And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and 9. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And complete into the hands of Fowler. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. And in a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified, big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Here we go now.
Back to throw now on first down. A dump off to Anderson. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
It's a five-receiver set, three to the left, two to the right. Again, he'll drop to throw. And his throw is going to be incomplete. Emmanuel Sanders, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up a third down. seventh play of the drive upcoming here on third and six. Defense sinking pass. They've got the nickel set out on third and six. Now Simeon. Oh, he can't hang on to it. Almost intercepted. They would have loved the first pick of the game there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And this score will stay right where it is. So it's an empty possession, and as a kicker, not the way you want to start your day's work.
And now each team's missed a field goal here so far, Brandon, so apparently neither guy is immune.
Start on the ground here with Bernard. And he'll take this one across the 45 up to about the 46-yard line. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up in the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Six yards to go here on second down. They'll run it here with Bernard. And he will be stopped here for no gain, and that is going to take us to the two-minute warning. The All-Pro Von Miller there on the tackle. Third down now following the run. Here's Bernard. It'll be a minimum pickup, and it will take us to the two-minute warning. It'll be a gain of two, and speaking of twos, it'll take us to the two-minute warning. Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. And there's a work of art right there. Out of bounds at the 2-yard line. Now this Broncos offensive unit ready to head back out onto the field. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline, they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time? Yeah, but, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
And he'll take this one up to about the 6-yard line. And quickly, they get to the line. Simeon. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
When you decide to run a hitch route, it really helps to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Fresh set of downs here. Thomas, the lone receiver, left. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. Oh, he
the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Virgil Green is tied in the intended receiver, and it'll be second and 10.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And Green with a catch left side. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. It's a gain of 7, and they're going to have a third down. And they're going to speed things up here. He'll drop to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. Demaryius Thomas, the intended receiver, and that's going to make it fourth down.
Really good, smart play by the defense, understanding third and short, guarding the first down sticks, and being able to make a play on the football and bat it down.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Got to try it here. He's back to throw. It's caught. He finds Norwood. Give him 8 on the play, and they're able to pick up the conversion here on fourth down. They'll look to throw here on first down. Norwood's got it complete. And he's brought down. Give him 16 on the pickup. And it's a first down for the Broncos. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. And the spike comes now with just under 40 ticks left. And the 8th play on this drive coming up.
Hang on now. Green 39. Green 39.
Now Simeon drops it underneath for Booker. Again with a juke. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45. And they're going to hurry back to the line now. Now he'll spike it here with 20 seconds to go on the clock. Ooh, long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
Here we go. Green 39. Green.
Simeon. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
One of the toughest things about playing defensive back is pattern reading, trying to figure out what they're doing. And on that one, they had to fly, just sending a guy downfield with the in route accompanying it, what people call a dagger route, trying to hit the guy underneath after the clear out. In this case, though, they're not able to get it done.
Yeah, they said forget the underneath route. They went for the guy on the fly, but as you said, incomplete. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Green alone out to the right. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. And they're not able to convert on fourth down. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. Only one timeout defensively, so this should just be a simple kneel down.
I agree totally. I looked at my time management chart. It says take a knee, victory formation. They just have one timeout left. And that should be all she wrote.
By the way, it's a good thing you can read that because nobody else can.
Not with my chicken scratch. Not at all.
The Bengals go down to a knee in the victory formation. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. The clock cannot be stopped here. Defense can't do anything. So kneel it down, take it home.
No doubt about it. It's what you practice for in winning situations each and every week. Victory formation. Take a knee. And go on into the locker room and celebrate.
Call it a victory. And this will likely be the last play and wrap things up. Dalton down to a knee, and that'll be all she wrote. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.